Hello, and welcome to my video. This video is about my favorite props of 2023. These props I worked on at my current job, which is an escape room company. One of the things I like about painting props and working as a scenic painter is learning and discovering techniques that can help transform a style, make something look more authentic, and refine my skill. I'm always learning from my peers with their insight on projects, and I think it's really cool and speaks of the talent of the teams who work here that help bring all this stuff together. Each part is really essential to making a successful game. This is the gun puzzle from the first photo. I unfortunately couldn't find that many photos on my drive, and the ones I did find, I actually forgot to move onto my phone. So here's just video of me calmly staining this. And this is actually a lot of fun, other than the fumes, which, you know, you shouldn't be breathing in. Definitely have to wear a mask. I really enjoyed this process. It was very fun utilizing the different color stains too. I'd never done that before. This is a picture that a colleague of mine drew per both of our suggestions, so it's like a collab, basically. Known as the spider sign, or spider hands sign. While I absolutely adore it, I wanted to make something in my own style, and even though it wasn't this necessarily, I wanted to challenge myself by delving into a new style, while also keeping some of the elements that I liked about both of these pictures. Now, I'm a romantic at heart, and while I was drawing this, I was daydreaming about one of my favorite characters back in the day as a kid, from James and the Giant Peach. Her name is Miss Spider.
Yeah, she'll just puncture your head and suck out the brains.
That I am saving for you.
Oh, pretty fast, long legs.
Such rude behavior.
And I thought this character would be a great match for her. I'm not a big fan of the shipping of Centipede and Miss Spider, so I don't know. I never really thought their personalities meshed that well together. They would express their love through poetry, comprised of the various love languages, spanning worlds, inspiring hearts and minds. I should have taken a picture of the final look, but I didn't. The only details that I added that isn't in this picture is the suspenders that I actually painted to look like a vintage 20s-30s camera reel. And I think there's like some minor details on his waistcoat too that I might have forgotten. Oh well. Anyways, I'm taking way too long with this, so moving on. And these groovy things are spider hands for the spider hand sign. These are UV reactive and they took quite a while building up the layers. So sort of a cheat move I did was actually like pouring, like doing pours of patterns over one over the other after a light sand and some touch-ups. So it looks like it took a long time, which it kind of did for drying, but other than the blue and pink striped one, the others didn't take that long in comparison. This is a gun crate that I worked on. It took quite a bit of different layers of scumbling with various metallic spray paints and latex paint.
This is the haunted wardrobe. And you're meant to actually step through here like it's a twisted version of the Narnia closet. These tendril looking things. came out of a spray can, basically a foam, like spray can with foam. And they harden over time. And you can paint over them with a elastic stuff, I forgot what it's called. Or you can just paint on straight with acrylic or latex paint. And then I used a Elmer's glue method where I do a gradation of black, gray, and white, and then go over it with the glue, and that's how you get this effect, this peeling effect. And I did it all over. Came out pretty sweet.
This was kind of like a side quest project, not like a typical prop project, if you will. I had so much fun with this. It's my like little alien shelf that I got to customize. I used a combination of acrylic, epoxy, and oil-based markers, I'm gonna say, Posca specifically. And of course, it is UV reactive. You know, I gotta hit you with that UV.
This is a resculpt of the Canon Lady based off of an original design. The body is pretty much the same. I just had to make some minor changes with matching the head of the Canon Lady, Canon Girl, to the rest of their body. I used game primer to prime the dolls so it could adhere to the foam better and make it easier to paint. It is very friendly with latex and acrylic-based paints. It was a lot of fun, too, because after I resculpted it, which took a while, because I wanted to get it as perfect as possible, painting it was kind of cathartic, seeing it, like, actually get fleshed out, so to speak.
Oh yay, it's Mr. Crispy. Mr. Crispy is a very early project, and very cool because I've never used plaster for something like this, and so much of it that I basically had to paint a new body on him. Mr. Crispy was burned in a terrible toxic waste accident, but still loves to love in the afterlife. And Goof too. So this is actually the most recent project that I've been working on, called the Architect Puzzle. The Architect Puzzle is 100% UV, and I had to basically draw out the patterns and sculpt out the patterns of the vines with epoxy foam, which is a new type of material that we've been testing out. It works pretty similarly to clay, to stone-based clay, but is very smushy. So you have to be careful when you're working with it at an earlier stage. I prefer to come back to it and smooth it out 30 minutes later because it's a lot more firm and I don't have to worry about smushing it. So So the thing about UV paints is that specifically for this project, it also has to look very... it has to look like it makes sense in the UV and in the regular light, but this is mostly exposed in UV light to people. It is a gateway portal type deal, hence the really cool looking portal outline, which took a while. Not as long as I thought it would, but the magenta layers were pretty thin and showed a lot of black through it even after the third layer. So while this one wasn't the most fun, which isn't always the point with these projects, they do teach me a lot, I did have to develop a new method to basically do an underscumble of bright orange, as you can see here, and assimilate wood grain on foam pre-cut wall boards that are fitted into a pod. I had to develop it and implement it efficiently enough because we were kind of in a time crunch at the time, and it went quite well. These were painted on different parts of the panel because we had to be careful not to overlap colors on colors, because the colors are very different from each other, as you can see in the middle part. That is actually going to be blue marble that kind of looks like the ocean. This was pretty fun to do. I quite enjoyed it. It's very basic, but it was fun basically painting a hunk of wood to look like a computer. This was the bane of my existence for a while. This prop is called Jive Hive, and it was a total pain in my ass at the time. I was in so much agony redoing the colors for this thing, and I had to learn a couple of very harsh lessons because I didn't save my colors properly, and I regretted it so much. Other than that, it was cool. There was a bit of a frustrating process to certain things, but I mean, it's part of the learning process as well, and there's definitely certain things that I don't want to repeat. This is a companion to the Jive Hive. And a more recent project of mine, months ahead of Jive Hive. So this is the Fairy Tale mural. Those are the paints that we were mostly working with because we had to have a fixed palette in order for everything to look cohesive, of course. These are big ass wall panels. And we used mostly a variety of different brushes to achieve the effects here, and sponges as well, especially with the fog effects. It's a fairy tale forest, but it has a creepy edge to it. Everyone did such a great job adding their style to it while also blending everything in so well. And the colors are gorgeous, look at them. This was a practice project basically on a smaller canvas. The canvas was still pretty big, but it's not a wall panel. And I wanted to try my hand at perspective and stone colors. I added a nice, well, right smack dab in the middle. Thank you for watching, if you made it this far. If you do like this type of stuff, please like, subscribe, comment, and yeah. More art stuff to come in a future near you.